The answer to 2.4, the value of k is equals to 12, and I will show you why that is the case. Let's do 2.1, 2.2, and 2.3 first. Okay, so 2.1. At a certain school, the staff committee wanted to determine how many glasses of water the staff members drank during a school day. Okay, all teachers present on a specific day were interviewed. The information is shown on the table below. Okay, and the first question, 2.1, complete the cumulative frequency column provided in the table in the answer book. Well, I don't have the answer book, so I'm just gonna put the cumulative table right here. So let me go ahead and do that. So on the first column, I'm just going to have 5. And then following 5, I'm gonna have 5 plus 15, which is 20. Okay. After that, I'm gonna have 20 plus 13, which is 33. Okay. 33 plus 5 is 38. 38 plus 2 is 40. So your table for the cumulative frequency should look something like this: 5, 20, 33, 38, and lastly 40. Okay, so that is 2.1. We are done with that. 2.2, on the other hand, how many staff members were interviewed? The staff members that were interviewed, 40. Okay, that is the total number of staff members when we add all these up: 5 plus 15, 20 plus 13, 33, plus 5 plus 2, 40. So we are 40 staff members at this school. That is 2.2. Okay, 2.3. How many staff members drank fewer than 6 glasses of water during a school day? So let's take a look at how our data is represented. So in this line, we have fewer than 6, right? As this is less than 6 and not less or equals to. So the people who drank fewer than 6 is 13 plus 15 plus 5. Those are the people that drank fewer than 6 glasses of water in a day. So 15 plus 13, 13 minus 2 is 28, okay? 28 plus 5, so we have 33. 33 people drank less than 6 glasses of water, which makes sense. Why are you drinking 6 glasses of water anyway? But that's not what we're interested in. Let's go ahead and do 2.4. The question we are really interested in, okay? This took me some time to figure out, but let me show you why I'm saying that k is equals to 12. K is equals to 12. If you didn't get 12, your answer is wrong. There is no way I answered this question using a lot of different methods, and the answer, k is equals to 12. There's no way around it. Okay, so the staff committee observed that K teachers were absent on the day of the interviews. Okay, it was found that half of these K teachers drank from 0 to fewer than 2. Okay, so let's make sense of that information from the get-go. Let's look at the column with the number of staff members. I want to show you something. Okay, so K teachers were absent, and then half of these K teachers drank between 0 and 2 glasses. So for 0 to 2 glasses of water, we have 5 plus k divided by 2, okay? Because we know that k divided by 2 teachers drink between 0 to 2 glasses of water. Let's carry on reading our information. While the remainder of them drank from 4 to fewer than 6. So 4 to fewer than 6, we have another k divided by 2. Okay, we have k teachers that were absent. Half of them drank between 0 and 2. Half of k is k divided by 2. And the remaining, which will be k divided by 2, drank between 4 to 6. So, yeah, the number of staff members for 4 to 6 is 13 plus k divided by 2. That is the important part. You need to be able to comprehend that in order to answer this question. Okay, let's carry on and hear the stories. When these K teachers are included in the data, the estimated mean is 4 glasses of water per staff member per day. How many teachers were absent on the day of the interviews? Basically, what is the value of K? Okay, so let's go ahead and compute that. The formula we have the mean being equals to the sum of the midpoint multiplied by the frequency divided by the cumulative frequency, the total number of staff members. Okay, so we need to find the mid and we need to multiply that mid with the frequency and then divide by the cumulative. Let me show you what I'm talking about, okay? So let's find the midpoint. So the first step is to find the midpoint. What is the midpoint of 0 to 2? That is 1. The midpoint of 2 to 4 is 3. That of 4 to 6 is 5. Of 6 to 8 is 7. Of 8 to 10 is 9. So that is the midpoint. And then we have the frequency, okay? So the frequency for 0 to 2, we know that it is 5 plus k divided by 2, followed by 15, and then 13 plus k divided by 2. For 7, the frequency is 5. For a midpoint of 9 glasses, the frequency is 2, okay? And then now we're supposed to have the midpoint multiplied by the frequency. So what is 1 multiplied by 5 plus k divided by 2? That will just give us 5 plus k divided by 2. Okay, 3 multiplied by 15, that's 45. And then what is 13 multiplied by 5? Let me just put that in my calculator real quick. So I have 65. I have 65 plus k divided by 2 multiplied by 5. So I have 5k divided by 2. 7 multiplied by 5 is 35. And then 9 multiplied by 2 obviously is 18. Okay. And then the total. Okay. I have to find my totals now. The total for the frequency. I know that the cumulative frequency was 40, right? So now I'm going to have 40 plus K, right? For the K teachers that were absent. Okay. That is quite easy to see. And then midpoint multiplied by frequency. I need the total for that. I'm going to add up the numbers first. So I have 5 plus 45 plus 65 plus 35 plus 18, which is 168. I have 168 plus 1 divided by 2k plus 5 divided by 2k. That is plus 3k. Okay, now we can go ahead and substitute on our formula. Let's not forget that we're supposed to come and substitute here. If we do that, we're going to have the mean, which is 4, being equals to the midpoint multiplied by the frequency, the sum. So that is 168 plus 3k divided by the cumulative frequency. That is 40 plus k. If we cross multiply, 4 multiplied by 4 is 16. So this will be 160 plus 4k, which is equals to 168 plus 3k. Okay, if I take 3k to the left hand side, I'm gonna have 4k minus 3k, which should be k. 168 minus 160 should be 8. Well, it seems like k is actually equals to 8 and not 12. Okay, which question do you want me to do next? Let me know in the comment section, which question do you want me to do next?